You want a beach here? Mimir, there was a shrine about a giant lady with lots of books and visions.
Ah, that would be Groa, the Knowledge Keeper. She was a gifted sorceress who gathered every tome of arcane wisdom she could find in the realms, all in the hopes of augmenting her powers of prophecy that she might find her lost husband, Aurvandil. But it was not her husband she would glimpse in her visions, for it was Groa, seeing longer and farther than any before or since, who witnessed Ragnarok, the end and the beginning. And Odin caught word of her ultimate prophecy. He maneuvered to obtain her knowledge and hoard it for himself.
No, what?
Tell us one later.
I almost wish they were harder. Is that weird? Can you finish that story you started?
Odin schemed to capture the visions of Ragnarok recorded by Groa, the Knowledge Keeper. Groa knew Odin as a long-time patron of her services, and so she welcomed him into her library as a friend. What she did not know is that Odin himself was behind her husband's disappearance, having used his enchantments to conceal his death at Thor's hands from her sight. Smiling, jealous Odin took her by the throat, and with his very hands he stole her library and her life for his own.
I always knew Odin was bad, but that's just...
Ruthless? Barbaric? Heartless? That's Odin. In fact, we would do well to sit in silence for the next few moments and reflect on Odin's capacity for evil. And so...
Reflect longer.
Fire! Stop it!
Nice shot.
Guy's part of his crew? That's a tough crew.
And all were his responsibility.
That's a lot of responsibility.
Does it frighten you? Responsibility.
No. I don't think so. I mean, I think it used to, but not as much anymore.
Why is that?
Well, being out here with you makes me feel more grown up.
Seen one of those before. Ooh, walk straight out of hell.
I see something down there.
Ed, you are full of stories. When will you tell one that entertains?
I beg your pardon?
He just insulted you.
Yeah, I got that. So you want a corker, do you? Very well, my brothers. I'll tell you the story of Hrungnir the Brawler. The real story.
There was a huge battle, right? His shrine had him in the middle, fighting off Aesir.
A pretty story, but no. Hrungnir, you see, was born with neither head nor heart. So the giants had to complete him with stone. He was strong, to be sure, but also a perfect simpleton. Odin met him wandering in Midgard one day, found him so amusing, so harmless, so gullible, that he invites him back to his palace in Asgard. There he gives Hrungnir his fill of mead, and goads him into all manner of boasts and antics, all for the amusement of the court. But I can just tell you this story later.
ordered a tactical retreat.
How did this one captain lead so many men?
He had their loyalty, so they followed.
And then they all died. He must have been a bad leader.
Why do you think that?
Well, he led all these men to their deaths.
True. But these men chose to follow.
Hmm.
Even good leaders make poor choices. The best take responsibility for them. Remember this.
Boy.
Sir. Okay. That's going in the journal. We've seen these runes before, but it's the kind I still can't read. I've seen these runes before, but it's the kind I still can't read.
Hmm. There's okay back there. Come on, get up, brother.
A dangerous beast. We will take him down together. Dangerous beast. We will take him down together. Boy.
Another map. Bet we'll find something useful here. Father. Were you ever a leader?
Many years ago, yes. I led men in battle.
Were you a good leader?
It is complicated.
Did you
ever... No more questions, boy. Focus on the task at hand.
Yes, sir. I see something down there.
Right then. We were in the middle of a story, weren't we? Odin had invited Hrungnir to his palace in Asgard, getting the simple giant drunk to amuse the court. I was there. I saw the Aesir laugh as Hrungnir leapt upon his shield and swore he'd kill us all and take our womenfolk back to Jotunheim. Then Thor shows up. And does he laugh? Oh no. Thor takes one look at the drunken stone buffoon and brings down Mjolnir on his head so hard that he's got chunks of Hrungnir in his own skull to this day. Thor is so startled by the faceful of rock, he doesn't notice Hrungnir's body topple right onto him with a sickening crunch. And again, the roars of laughter echo through the palace halls.
That's an awful story, Mimir. Nothing like the ones Mother told me.
Or I can just tell you this story later.
Come here. Can you finish that story you started?
I can indeed. Where were we?
Thor.
Thor smashes the stone head of Brunnir, who falls upon him with a sickening crunch. Let that be a lesson, my son. Truth is seldom so pretty as myth and legend.
I have a question. If Ymir was the first giant, where did he come from?
In the beginning, there was Gnúmgagap, the Great Void. There were no realms yet, only primordial forces. There was fire, and there was ice. And there in the void, they met and produced.
You know what?
I'll tell this one later.
We're not getting in there without a key.
Right then, we were in the middle of a story, weren't we? Regarding Ymir. Primordial fire and ice met in the great void, producing water.
Water?
More than water. The mystic lifeblood of something entirely new. From this water, Ymir took form and became a being of pure creation and chaos, mother and father to all that came after.
Even the Aesir?
Aye. Every god, man, and beast came first from Ymir's flesh. Though it was the Aesir who thought themselves so superior that they should hold dominion over the rest of creation. It was Odin who took arms against his creator and spilled Ymir's lifeblood with his spear. A necessary evil, he would say, to bring order to the realms. From Ymir's torn flesh, Odin would fashion the realm of Midgard for his own. Called himself All-Father, as if he was the creator, and not the creator's destroyer. The small, covetous tyrant!
Ymir?
Huh? Oh. Sorry, my boy. You know, I think it best we just end it there, actually.
Your boy could use a hand! Your boy, he needs help! You've got your boy!
Father, I need you! Looks like we got him all.
Be ready. Nice shot.
Look here, another.
This one is thin. A frost giant king.
Correct. A cunning one as well.
Is that Mjolnir? Did he steal Thor's hammer?
Aye, for a time.
A lot of these seem to end with Thor killing them.
Imagine that.
Another name.
Kara!
Another Valkyrie. That's no coincidence. But who'd have etched them on Tyr's braziers?
Mimir, what can you tell me about that giant lady with the bow?
She was called Skadi, Queen of the Hunt. Her father was Thjotsi, who could take the shape of any wild creature, and taught Skadi how to hunt them all. But I can just tell you this story later.
Another piece of the language cipher. Good.
So, if you remember, I'd started a doozy of a story earlier.
It's about Scar, the Queen of the Hunt.
And we'll pick this up later.
Another name. Rota!
Another Valkyrie. That's no coincidence. But who'd have etched them on Tyr's braziers?
I told you. We should come back with the cipher. So let me get this straight. We're not in Vanna. Right now, even though we're walking through the Vanaheim Tower?
Correct. We are still in Midgard. This tower is just a mirror of an identical tower in Vanaheim that exists in this same spot. Here in Midgard, just simple. We would need to use the realm travel room to get to Vanaheim.
Confused.
Be grateful it works at all.
If you remember, but I'd started a doozy of a story earlier.
It was about Scar, the Queen of the Hunt. From the ribs of pack beasts, she fashioned second feet, allowing her to glide upon the snow so no animal could evade her. She became a huntress beyond compare, even to any god. Odin himself wanted her for his bride, believing she would bear him strong sons. But she spurned his affections, and for that insult, Odin vowed revenge. It was put forth that the Aesir were plagued by an eagle who would steal the precious golden apples of Idun.
You know what?
I'll tell this one later.
Mimir, you're in the middle of a story before.
Was I? Oh, yes! Seeking revenge on Skadi the Huntress, Odin spread rumors that Aesir were plagued by an eagle. Not even the finest archer among the gods could bring it down. Odin knew that Skadi could not resist the temptation to prove herself superior, and so she joined the hunt. Skadi tracked the eagle as it flew where she alone could glide, and loosed an arrow from her unerring bow. And we'll pick this up later. Right then, we were in the middle of a story, weren't we? Skadi, Queen of the Hunt, had been lured by Odin into hunting an eagle. When she collected her quarry, she found no eagle at all. But her own father, poor Thjotsi, slain by his own daughter. She was overcome with grief and shame. For there is nothing nature so reviles as a child who kills their parent. Skadi succumbed to her fate as winter's blanket fell, holding her father as the mountain held her in an embrace to last eternity.
Well, that was sad.
Aye. There aren't many happy endings for the giants, I'm afraid.
They're huge. I wonder why they aren't moving. We can beach over here. They were pretty weak. You want a beach here?
Our enemies are strong.
we need to deal with that. There's got to be a better tool for this job. This may need something we don't have. This may need something we don't have. There's something down there.
Mm-hmm.